So originally I was planning to devote today's episode on dealing with holes in the dune that you're flying. And when I was making the footage from that, flying my paraglider along the beautiful Dutch coast the other day, I encountered one of my buddies, I landed next to him, and then this happened. He got into an ever-increasing pendulum, which almost led to him experiencing what the Russians call a very bad day. Now, this is a situation that I've seen happen quite a lot of times, but never have I gotten the chance to get it on camera. So I think this deserves some priority now. This was an unintended pendulum. This was not something that the pilot was actually trying to do. Actually, it was something he was trying to fix. And this, combined with the strong wind, could have led to a very dangerous situation. Time to take a closer look at that. Welcome to Flight Coach. My name is Bas van Duin, and it is my mission to help you get more out of your life and flying career through having less stress and more skills. Today, we're going to talk about the skill of getting yourself unstuck. So as a short introduction to what was actually happening here, is that I was flying around getting some nice footage for you guys for my episode on dealing with holes in the dunes. And then I encountered one of my buddies, Rudolf, who was flying here with his beautiful purple wing. The wind was pretty strong and we had a little chat on the ground, and he asked me, "Boss, can you make some video recordings of my takeoff and perhaps give me some feedback on that?" Little did we know that stuff was almost about to go pretty wrong. So let's start from the beginning of the video that I took. You can see him walking up the dune. It's all pretty controlled, nice little kiting. Yeah, I'm not a very big fan of that. You know, that brake, whole brake switching thing there, having to cross over the brakes because you start with the brakes actually in the wrong hand. That has a lot of downsides, but that's not the topic of today's video. Maybe I'll cover that in another one. Let's move on. So he's in control. You can see him looking at the direction that he's going to fly in. You can see he has good brake control, good body position, and he's lifting off. And immediately you can see his weight shifting. You can hear me cheering because initially I thought it was going to be pretty fun, but then you can see the shaking gets more violent. And at this point in time, I decided to stop filming because I wanted to have all my attention in giving him some advice, shouting at him from the ground. So no more video from here, but to show you what actually happened, I'll bring up some simulation that I made because I recreated what was actually happening so we can talk about that. So showing you via the simulation I made what actually happened was this, but this is at roughly half the speed the actual events unfolded. So he was in quite a violent pendulum, and all that time he was losing altitude. You can see him getting closer and closer and closer to the dune. Now you may think, what's the problem here? Well, there actually are two main problems in this situation. The first one, of course, being that it is entirely likely when the wind is this strong and this cross, that you slam into the dune, having a sideways impact against the dune, which will really hurt your body. Even if that does not happen and somehow you manage to come down softly, the bigger, maybe the even bigger risk will unfold, and that is your body not being able to move again in relation to the wing. And what happens then in such a strong wind? The body stays stationary and the wing itself starts moving because of the airflow. And then you get something that looks like this. And you don't want that. Let's back it up a little bit. What actually happens, and you can see it here, the wind is blowing against your wing. Your body has become sort of a fixed position, a position around which the wing starts rotating, gets pushed against the dune. The wing comes in the so-called power zone, and it starts dragging you across the dune, allowing you to end up on the wrong side of the dune, getting pulled over and having a very bad day. Now let's have a look at the actual wind conditions. So here we have the windsock looking top down at it now. And you can see wind is almost at a 60 degree angle relative to the dune. So these are pretty challenging conditions to be flying in, but very possible once you're a skilled pilot. So if we symbolize the wind direction with an arrow, it would look something like this. Now, of course, we can place that arrow anywhere because for the sake of simplicity, we can say that the wind everywhere in our little virtual world here would be identical. Yes, I know when you get close to the dune, the rotation actually changes quite a bit, but for the purposes of this video, that's not really important. So we can move that arrow anywhere. Let's move it closer to Rudolf so you can see that this was the wind that he was facing. And by holding on to his risers while adjusting the trimmers and moving his weight in a bit of a gusty wind, he was actually inducing this momentum, this pendulum himself. We also have a name for that. It's called pilot-induced turbulence. What he's actually doing is fighting this blue arrow because he noticed that he was getting closer to the dune and he was trying to get away from it by increasing his speed. But there is an easier way to do this. Let's look at this arrow and divide it into the two components that it exists of. One facing the dune, and of course one parallel to the dune. Now, wouldn't it be a lot easier if you just had to fly into this red component? That's like half or maybe a third of the length, so of the strength of this arrow. That of course means that you have to change your course. You can't be flying straight into wind, but you have to fly on a 90 degree angle away from the dune. Let's see how that would look like. So he's going to try again, but this time following the advice that we've just given him, flying in the straight line away from the dune, shortest route possible to the sea. You can see he starts moving to the left because of course the component pushing him to the left in this perspective is still there. But he starts moving away from the dune. He actually has enough altitude to regain a good flying angle and he can get back into the lifting zone. And even though it's slow because he's facing that headwind, remember the green arrow, he just gets airborne. And let's look at that from a different perspective. Rewind it a little bit. So here he was trying it again. And you can clearly see he's still losing altitude while he's correcting this pendulum, but he has way more time because he increases the distance he has to the dune. He starts moving to the left, but now he has his glider under control again, flies back into the lifting area towards the sunset. So if this video brought you some new insights, I would love to hear from you in the comments down below. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to do so. And if this video brought you some value, don't forget to press that like button. See you next time. See you in the air.